lot of people is asking if how far is the travel from Bahrain to Saudi Arabia. So today I'm gonna show you kung ilang minutes ba talaga ang or gaano kalayo ang Saudi ang Bahrain to Saudi. I will come from Bahrain today, so I'm going to Saudi Arabia. So, okay. If you can see that blue, whatever is that, it says there King Fahad Causeway. King Fahad Causeway, yun ang bridge going to Saudi Arabia. So, the first stop is, if your car is a Bahraini car, you have to first get an insurance, pay the insurance over here. Pero kung bayad ka na, pwede ka na diretso. Kasi normally you can buy insurance daily, monthly, or yearly insurance for your car. And then the next step, you're going to pay for the toll. So ito na yung, bali yung, ito na yung pinaka main ng bridge. Nag-start na tayo, papunta na ng Saudi. The toll, you have to pay 25 riyals. Morning,
thank
sir.
You,
hello. Yeah, bye-bye.
Thank
you. And God you, bless.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Yeah, I know him. That old man. So, okay. Tapos na kami magbayad ng toll. So, I think it's like 10 kilometers from that booth to the next stop. The next stop will be the like car paper. Kung allowed ba ang car mo papasok ng Saudi Arabia. Kasi ang Bahrain is different country and Saudi Arabia is iba din. So, chine-check kung ang, if your car is Bahraini car, titingnan kung allowed ba yung car mo na lumabas ng Bahrain. Kasi kung hindi, let's say for example, yung mga hindi bayad, yung mga naka-loan, I think kung naka-loan, bank loan, it's under your name, so I think it's allowed. Pero yung mga company cars, normally, they have to get permission from their office or from their company na ita-travel nila yung car outside Bahrain or outside Saudi Arabia. So, okay, ito na yung bridge at ito yung, well, ito yung normal na madadaanan going, ito yung normal na madadaanan going to Saudi nga or vice versa, from Saudi to Bahrain or Bahrain to Saudi. Oh, hindi ko pala na time. So, the time is 9:13. Siguro when we left the toll, it was like around 9:11. So, okay. Tingnan natin kung ilang minutes ba talaga. Actually, ang minutes ng travel, depende yon sa traffic. Kung during peak hours, it might take you as long as 4 hours to reach, you know, Bahrain or to reach Saudi Arabia. 4 hours. That was before. So, ngayon ata mga 2 hours na lang. So, pero pag hindi naman busy, just like now, it's a Thursday morning, although pa-weekend na, pero dahil maaga pa, hindi pa to busy ang bridge or ang causeway, that what we call it. Yeah. So, medyo malayo-layo din. It's like, how many kilometers, honey? It's like 10 kilometers, yeah?
Yeah, 25 altogether.
Yeah, 25 kilometers altogether from end to end. Bahrain to end of Saudi Arabia na kung dun-dun ka na sa south side. So, okay. Kung nakikita nyo yung mga cars na approaching, they came from Saudi Arabia. Kami naman, we're heading to Bahrain. today is Thursday actually and I'm off today. But then I'm going to Saudi kasi I left my car there yesterday, so kukunin ko siya. Masyadong view aside sa sea, wala ka nawang talaga makita dito actually. Ang causeway at Bahrain side or even sa Saudi side dapat 100 kilometers lang per hour ang speed limit. But since walang camera or speed trap dito sa side ng Bahrain, ang mga drivers or ang mga sasakyan tumatakbo 180, 160 ganyan. Madalang ka makakita ng nagda-drive ng very few are driving or following the speed limit. As long as alam mo naman na safe naman wala namang car sa front or sa side, okay lang. Kung makita mo yung mga skid marks na yan sa road, actually like few months ago may na-aksidente dito. I think ito pa yung may black part. Ayan. Ito siya. Yan. Yung black na yan is yun ng doon nasunog yung truck. I think it was like a 16-wheeler truck. Basta mahaba siya na truck. Binangga siya ng maliit na sasakyan ng kotse. Lasing ang driver or hindi siguro nakatulog. So, binangga siya. Then, pumutok or whatever. Nag-explode. Dahil yung truck na yun, syempre they travel, they're traveling sa mga malalayong lugar, they have, ako ay suspected yung LPG tank, kasi may LPG dun na kung saan sila nagluluto na mga drivers. So yeah, we're now heading to, we're approaching the immigration. So siguro sa immigration, I'm not allowed to take video, so tago ko muna or I'll let you know kung ilang minutes ba talaga. We left 9:11, so now the time now is 9:17. Yeah, so we'll see how long will it take us to arrive Saudi Arabia. Oh yeah, so yon. Okay.
Thanks a lot, sir. Bye-bye.
Morning.
Annie's at work, isn't she?
Yeah. So we're done. Okay, we're done with the two immigrations. Ano ba normally ang ginagawa dun sa ano bang ginawa namin? Okay, first they're going to give us the car paper, yung bang check na okay, you're ikaw yung allowed na driver na magagamit ng car na to. And then the next stop is the Bahrain immigration. Then after Bahrain immigration, it's gonna be Saudi immigration, of course. Then after Saudi immigration, before kapa lalabas or the last stop, it's gonna be the customs. So the customs, you have to queue. Of course, same din sa immigration, you have to queue sometimes. You have to queue and then they will check your car. And ang checking ng car, depende din. If you have a lot of stuff inside the car, so, yun parang exciting yun sa eyes nila. So, sometimes, iche-checkin nila yun lahat. Everything, by hand. I-open at i-tingnan. Depende sa luck mo din. If worst comes to worst, they might take your car to the x-ray. Kasi meron na rin silang parang x-ray na dadaan ka lang, then i-x-rayin yung whatever inside the car. So, yeah, ito, we're in Saudi side. So, meron ng mga speed drop. If you notice, people are driving very carefully kasi every flash ng camera will cost them 300 riyals or 30 BD. No, it's 300 riyals lang. Kasi pag yung plate number mo is Bahrain, ang sabi is hindi pa siya nakasync sa Saudi Arabia. So, kahit ilang flash yan, sabi daw wala ka daw babayaran, which is free. So, ito. since we're driving a Saudi car or a Saudi plate number na car, so yun, kailangan namin mag extra cautious. Otherwise, ilang kamera to, ilang 300 riyals ang babayaran namin just for a day. So yeah, bridge ulit ito. We're heading to Al Khobar, Saudi Arabia. My home for 16 years. Yeah. Kung hindi clear ang video ko today, dahil this is just like a sample, I'll do it again next time if I have time. Unfortunately, I cannot do it by myself alone when I'm driving kasi I don't have this car accessories wherein you can put, you know, your mobile and all. But tapos tuloy-tuloy yung video. No, I don't have that. So, kaya lang ako nakapag-chance ngayon dahil I have a driver next to me. Okay, so I think we left at 9:12 and now it's 9:26. So 14 minutes and we're almost there. We will almost reach the end of the bridge. Yeah. Marami ng mga ibon na nagma-migrate ngayon kasi papasok na yung ano, cold season. We call it winter but then hindi naman ganun kalamig. Okay. So, to kung yung makikita nyo sa malayo, that is already Saudi Arabia. That is already part of Saudi Arabia. Yun ang tinatawag nilang Al Khobar, Saudi Arabia. Okay, the time now is 9:27. So, 15 minutes na tayo from the toll station. 15 minutes na ang travel time natin. That's including na ang immigration. So, it's not bad. Actually. Kasi as I said, minsan umaabot yan ng 1 hour, 2 hours, or sometimes more. Dati nga na-experience ko, 1 o'clock ako umalis, dumating ako ng Bahrain, 6 p.m. na. Dahil sa sobrang traffic, aside sa sobrang traffic, hindi siya nagalaw. As in, stuck ka talaga. As in, hindi gumagalaw yung mga road. Ang mga sasakyan, I mean. So, pag ganyan, it's either sobrang busy lang talaga or system down. Yeah, malapit na, malapit na. As you can see there, that is already Al Khobar, Saudi Arabia. Pero andito pa rin tayo sa bridge. Nasa gitna pa rin tayo ng dagat. So, okay, patapos na. We're almost there. Patapos na yung bridge. So, it's 9:29. It's 17 minutes. Okay. So, eto na. Nasa land area na tayo. Wala na tayo sa dagat. ng Khobar, ng nandito tayo sa Saudi. This is already Saudi Arabia. Welcome to Saudi Arabia, Al Khobar. So it's the time now is 9:29. So it's 17 minutes. Okay, bye-bye. Next video I'll show you Al Khobar. Bye, ciao.